We're recording.
Okay, hello everyone. Thanks for joining me this afternoon in our second session, which is all going to be about your impact. I'm Kathleen Shaw, and I'm a Chartered Fellow of the Institute of Personnel and Development. I've got a background in talent acquisition or recruiting. I've also been working more recently in learning and development with BMW, one of our clients, and I've also had a broadcasting career as a hobby. I'm passionate about impact and the impact that we have on others. I'm really interested in the whole science behind it, and really pleased that we'll be looking at something today. So, motivation, when we think about motivation, our motivational styles and how we behave actually has an impact on how people perceive us. So, you know, we've maybe looked at personal impact, what is it? How do other people who have good impact upon ourselves? But it's also quite important to think about behaviour, our behaviour, and how we can impact on others. Just a quick 2 minutes to think about impact. What is it to you? Just maybe in your threes, just have a quick discussion around what is impact? What does it mean to you?
The impact can always be positive or negative. If I have a good feeling, I can't communicate going further with that person because they've left a very, very negative impact on you.
Memorable,
so
memorable, yeah.
Feel like they're talking to you.
Yeah.
It's very
personal impact they have on you. It does feel like they want to be open with you and they want to share themselves with you.
So that makes it memorable when somebody remembers you or treats you in such a way that you feel that they've engaged with you, they've connected with you. Perhaps they might listen to you, maybe?
Yeah.
I think we have influence on you.
So influence is coming out, so being engaging, having influence.
Is that positive or negative?
So yes, I wanted to make that distinction. It can either be positive or negative, but they have some form of influence. Anything else?
Memorable
again, that's what you mentioned again. Yes? Anything else?
The behaviour and the words and the tone and the language, all the stuff, has an imprint on you.
Yes.
Now that's not a conscious thing necessarily that we take away, but with the influence that we just heard about, it possibly may have a subconscious change on your style going forward, along with all the other people's influences that you network with. And it creates a slight nurture of your personality as you grow through life.
So there's something around the influencing, something around who we are. You mentioned behaviour, so it's also part and parcel of, you know, our personality, our behavioural preferences, our behavioural traits, which motivate us as well, our motivators and drivers, which influence how we come across to others. And what we see in other people who we admire or who we think are people who have good impact, good personal impact, is useful surely for us in terms of what we admire in others, what works for us in others. We can also try to practice those attributes and skills. And you mentioned behaviour. I think there's also motivation as well. Anything else that anyone had? So calmness, remembering your name, somebody who engages with us makes impact, has positive or negative impact on us. Somebody who influences us. If we think about some of the leaders in the world, previous, current leaders who influence, they get people following them, don't they? They have a message, something that they are communicating. Being memorable again, the subconscious. So we all have personality traits. We all have the motivators and drivers that make us work. And sometimes
would be people who also stand up for you for whatever reason. Yeah, it's so memorable because you remember them.
I might think about somebody perhaps has got the wow factor as well, that's taken a time to listen to you or maybe to hear your message. Is that what you were saying?
So
thank you so much, Jazz. Behaviour and motivation, those are the ones I want to have a look at. So I've actually got a questionnaire here which I'm going to give to you to fill out. And what we're trying to work out here is what is your motivational style, what motivates you. So before you fill out, just pass it on. Thank you. Managing your impact on others. Confidence. It helps with your relationships. It shows whether you've got that compassion. We talked about listening to other people, and when you feel that you've been listened to, that all helps. How we give feedback, or how feedback is given to us. In terms of our working styles, so not just going for a job interview or networking, it's how the team is constructed. It helps with how we do problem solving, how we handle conflicts in a team. So that's why it's really important to know the impact that we have on others and the impact that others have on us. So if you just want to look at this questionnaire, 2-3 minutes to complete it. So basically, you just need to allocate a total of 10 points to each of the sections. So for instance, I really like it when, if you think things are really done correctly should be 3 points. Things are done amicably should be 3 points. You've allocated 6. which means that I've achieved something difficult before. So each of those boxes must add, it might be, you think, it's 10 for things that are done amicably and 0 for the others. So just for each question, filling that out, you're thinking about as others would see you, as well as how you see yourself, just allocate 10 sets of points through 10 questions. In the first column, all the boxes in the second, and all the boxes in the third. Up what's in the first, second, third column? Some of you are still working on that.
Yeah, just one more word.
Yes, okay. Totting up. Okay. Any thoughts on any of this? Surprised?
I think you try and figure out which one you are, and I think I'd be the bottom right.
Okay, an adapter, because when we look at this a bit later on today, we'll actually measure that. Do we believe that behaviour really does have an important impact on how we are seen by others?
Absolutely.
In what way?
Actions speak louder than words.
Actions speak louder than words. Yeah. Anything else?
And you could be very different.
You probably need a balance in a team.
In the team, yes. Mm-hmm. So do you think that anyone's style, do you think you need all carers, all professional people?
No.
Why not? So we're talking about dynamics as well. How do you think our motivational style might affect our behaviour and thereby the impact that we have on others?
If you don't behave in a way, for example, that's respectful to others, you're automatically going to create conflict, yeah, aren't you? So, whereas if you behave in a way that's respectful, then you're going to create more harmony and then you're going to get better results.
Mm-hmm.
So,
yes,
that's how behaviour works.
Okay. I think that's what we're going to end on today, the idea of this differing approach. There's no right way. I know we're going to explore each of your marks in a little while, but with some of us, we can work between these different traits, if you like, and some of us are adaptive, so we flex. But it's important to know those attributes in terms of knowing how we can impact others, and more importantly, how others can impact us. Any questions?